the coach of Errol Spence. I talked to Pita, Robert's son, who works the corner. He said he gave you a lot of credit for an amazing game plan. He said Derrick James, not only was it nice, because he was in your locker room when you were wrapping up.
Yeah.
He said you guys were very friendly, you weren't rude, you weren't mean. Tell me about the whole fight.
It wasn't even about that, man. It was about showing and proving who he really was. I mean, this is a sport. We couldn't live our lives and do what we do if we didn't have those guys to do it with, right? So no need to ever be mad or disrespectful or angry. You know, I did yell at him. I was like, y'all need to stop the fight, is what I said to them. And he, Peter said, he gave me the finger. Like,
when? During the fight?
Yeah. I was like, y'all got to stop the fight. It was like almost unnecessary, you know what I mean? Moral victories are not even worth having because it takes so much out of you. I mean,
but we were all impressed with Errol tonight. The way he moved, it was a different Errol Spence that we're normally seeing, and obviously very successful. Mikey Garcia, what did he impress you with tonight?
I think Mikey, his toughness, man, his ability to never give up. He kept fighting all the way through the fight. I mean, he kept trying, man. Even when he was outgunned, outmanned, he started trying to load up a little bit, trying to land big shots. I mean, that's phenomenal. I mean, that's the guy. First of all, you think about the guy take a challenge like that, and then he fights all the way through the whole fight. Well, even in the last round, he's like, man, it's amazing, man.
I was thinking the guys at 47 that are not interested in fighting Earl because they know what's going to happen.
Well, possibly. You know,
they fight. But what do you do next?
Hey, Manny Pacquiao was a little hesitant to get in the ring tonight.
What did he say in the ring? I
couldn't even hear him.
He said maybe.
Sean Porter didn't do it. He I don't know.
So what does Earl do? Move up to 54, 60, 68, 75?
He's going
to
say 147, man. He's funny.
Fight whoever's in there with him.
He's going to fight 147. I mean, they're going to fight him. I mean, I think that, it's not worth going down that road if it's not worth it financially. So, I mean, it's a business, and I think that the money's right. They're on pay-per-view right now. So I think it shouldn't be an issue with those guys taking a fight like that.
How does Micky Garcia do with other 147 fighters?
I don't know. I mean, I think that it works well if you have a perfect opponent who wants to dance with him, right? Meaning that if they want to stand there in front of him and fight, he's going to kill him. He's going to kill you. You know, just like the other left-handed guy who won the title with you, the guy from
Dejan Natatanin. Oh, yeah. He was the Mike Tyson at 130.
I think that, but Mike, he's great, man. Just L. We had a great strategy, great game plan. I mean, that was just it.
And what kind of feedback did you get in the locker room? Did Manny go in there? Did Floyd go in there?
No, but Floyd was talking to me the whole time.
What was he saying? What was he telling you?
Look at him go to the body shot. He kept yelling out, have that same energy. That's what he just kept saying over
and
over.
Floyd was saying that?
Yeah, over and over and over the whole time, yeah.
And after the fight?
He was gone. It was like he was in the ring. I mean, he's happy, and then it was kind of over, you know.
Now, Coach, people don't notice about you, but you had about 400 amateur fights yourself.
Yeah.
That's a lot of amateur fights.
A lot of amateur fights, man.
Why so long? Why not turn pro after 100?
I mean, you know, because we started boxing at 5 years old.
Oh, you started five?
Pee-wee boxing, yeah.
Wow.
So pee-wee boxing, box. We had fights every weekend. That's kind of how you just keep fighting.
So how many belts and trophies do you have in your house then?
We had a lot of trophies, but my garage was full of them, and we threw them all away. It was just too many of them. But I do have some of my three Golden Glove trophies, probably.
What do you tell all Errol Spence fans tonight if they're watching?
What do I tell them what?
Fans of Errol Spence right now, if they're watching.
Hey, man, I just tell them thank you for all the love and all the support. And not even all not people not fans, but everybody got involved and got engaged. That's really what it's all about.
Now, 48,000 people. 48,000 right, people. Right, in boxing, if we get 8,000, it's amazing. 12,000 is a record.
Yeah, man, Terrence Crawford getting 10, and they happy about it. I mean, no disrespect to Terrence Crawford, just saying he's another big name guy. But, hey, 48,000, man, listen, with Manny, it's probably going to be more than that. At this point now, this is a transition to where you see a guy who's, whatever, now he's an overnight celebrity, 20-year overnight celebrity. That's what it is right now. That's what you see.
It's like the old saying, it took me 10 years to become an overnight sensation.
That's right, but
Earl's very talented, very skilled. We saw another side of him tonight. Any idea who you would want next if it was up to you?
I don't get into that. My job is just to train him.
Once they tell you who the opponent is.
But yeah, I don't
okay.
I don't want to,
What's next for Charlo?
It's a rematch. Yeah, ordered rematch from the WBC, so we'll get ready to start working on that now.
Harrison, right? Tony Harrison?
Huh?
Tony Harrison?
Yeah.
When is that? Do you know?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Coach James, let me ask you a question. You being a master coach, you know, I know you ain't had time to actually study the film, but when you look at Errol's performance, what do you take away from it? I mean, is there anything that you felt that he could have improved on or anything? I know you always want to, you know, take something away from the fight.
Yeah. I told him he did a couple things wrong. He just, you know, I told him he was kind of too high up. When Mikey boxes so high up, he's not here. He boxes from here. So that's, and a couple times Errol was a little high too. So I made say, you gotta get lower. Give me big knees more than that. And he kind of was up a little too high. But that was one of the things that I get right off the top of my mind.
Do you think any other 35 pounder would do as good as Mikey in there?
I don't know, man.
You want to try?
Mikey, I think that we did enough of that 135-pound fighters. I think it's the welterweight guys. Enough of those guys out there to be dealing with them to deal with another 135-pounder.
By the way, Thomas Hill won tonight.
Yeah.
Tell us about him. He was in camp with
you guys. I didn't see the fight, though. But you know what? The thing about it that happened, every guy from our gym had a knockout tonight. That's where three knockouts. Then Thomas Hill had a victory, and Adrian Taylor had a victory, but Errol went the distance. He kind of killed him.
Thomas sparred Errol, and he told me Errol hits harder than a heavyweight because he sparred heavyweight.
Yeah, he can punch him down. Mikey's up, man. Mikey, I think it was unnecessary to take take that over.
I talked to him. I was right with him. He said he didn't feel it. It didn't really affect him. So he was telling me.
We'll talk to him in the morning. I box and you're gonna be sore, man. You can hit it on the arm, it's gonna be sore the next day. Yeah.
Did you have any conversations with Errol, coach, about any private conversations that you can disclose in regards to him being surprised with anything, as far as Mikey's craftiness?
I just practiced the punches that I saw Mikey throw over and over. I would kind of like keep throwing the uppercut, keep going straight right. That's what I thought. Going into the fight, I thought this. I said, Mikey only has two options, maybe a third. The two options is the shorter. Listen, first option is to go after him, right? Second option is to wait for him and try to catch him walking in. The third one is to try to counterpunch him. So we were preparing for those options. And when you take those options away, he never came forward. And every time Mikey came to him, he controlled the distance and the range. And Mikey tried to throw counter punches, but Errol was counter punching also. So it was kind of like, he had only so many options. And we kind of like accepted that and just went from there.
Dick, I had to ask you, how was the ring walk? Who was the singer?
It was like Yo Beezy and Trap Boy Freddy. Yeah, out.
The fireworks. Man.
Hello? Oh. Nope. Yeah.
All right, so there you have it, Derrick James. You can follow him at Derrick D. James?
Yeah.
One?
D. James 1. Yeah.